Joining me now from Mexico City is Laura Carlson. She's the director of the Americas Program at the Center for International Policy. So, Laura, describe for me what you've seen there in Mexico, the reaction there, not just when it came to the presidential election, but also the local, state, and federal elections. What were voters saying this time around?
Very important. We saw an outpouring of joy. Really, as soon as the news was out that Andrés Manuel López Obrador had won the elections. And it's an extraordinary sea change in Mexican politics. After decades of a neoliberal, free market, economic policy, what he was offering was something really quite different. It remains to be seen how much margin of maneuver he has and how far he can go with it, but he's looking at programs to redistribute wealth, which is why the poor people really believed in a change under his government. And what we've seen is that it wasn't only focused on the presidency. We're not talking here about the power of a charismatic personality to gain support in a country that's basically very disillusioned with its current governors. What we're really talking about is a political program that people were convinced could be an alternative to this disaster that's happening now. Out of 9 state governorships, it looks like Morena's going to take, that's his National Regeneration Movement, his party will take 5 of those. And they are also talking now about having a majority in both houses of Congress. So this is a very strong statement on the part of the Mexican people that they want a change.
And Laura, you know, he's promising a lot of reform, especially when it comes to fighting corruption. Is this an example, though, of reality being different than what you say on the campaign trail? Because how difficult will that be for him to accomplish?
Well, Elaine, you mentioned the issue of corruption, and that has really been the center of his campaign. And that's perhaps the easiest issue to attack within Mexico, because if a president were to come in and begin to really investigate the kind of corruption, the crooked contracts, the under-the-table payments that are a part of political life on a daily basis here, they could send a strong message that this is not the way we'll be operating any longer. And just with that message and the message that people won't be able to get away with it anymore, that could make a huge difference, and it could make a huge difference rather rapidly.
This was López Obrador's third time running for president. He obviously wasn't successful before. So what do you think was different this time around?
The main thing is that different, especially from the 2012 campaign, because there's a historical debate still about whether or not he really lost the 2006 campaign. It was a half a percentage point of difference, and there were a lot of indication that there were some dirty tricks there when Felipe Calderón won. But the big difference between this one and the 2012 campaign is that they played heavily on fear. They said López Obrador is just a president for the poor. The middle class and the ruling class will suffer losses under his presidency. He'll go after what you have. And people bought into that. There was a very strong press campaign against his presidency. So what's the difference now? The difference now is that the status quo has become indefensible, basically. The violence increased to the most violent year last year on record in the last 20 years. It's out of control in many parts of the country. And the economy has had almost no growth on a per capita basis. And real wages have gone down. So what people figured is that the uncertainty of a new party and a new president coming in was far less dangerous than the continuation of the situation we have now. And that caused them to take that step of supporting a new project instead of being afraid to change from the existing situation.
All right, Laura Carlson in Mexico City. We always appreciate your insight. Thank you for joining us.